Hi, everybody, and welcome back. It's Thursday in the 22nd, another beautiful day. The neighborhood is winding down with one more to come, thanks to a lot of high pressure, giving way to a lot of warm and dry air, and one more beautiful day in the neighborhood. And all of it's going to come to a crashing halt as a cold front makes its way into the Ohio Valley over the course of your weekend. Some showers that will linger on into early next week, so I hope you've had time to enjoy a beautiful stretch of some gorgeous fall weather. Today has been one of those days, like many have been around here lately. News here, time here. In fact, our top story tonight was one that I was saving for tomorrow, thinking foolishly that it might be one that I could use, have pre-done, and get out a little early and enjoy a beautiful Friday afternoon. Well, I've got a great deal of news that's just not ready to air tonight that we'll get into tomorrow night, a lot of it having to do with fall and Halloween festivities and things of that nature, and some other reports. So tonight, it's Community Day coverage, and this report is one of those great stories that really encompasses most everyone who, in some form or fashion, either by donating as a business, being there as a member of the audience or a member of a club or organization, in some form or fashion, nearly everyone watching this had something to do with Community Day. It was a record-setting event, not in attendance, but in other good ways. And we'll take you to the ceremony where they got their checks just a few days ago. Got that edited down nice and tidy, and I think you'll enjoy hearing what all these folks are planning on doing with the money that they so desperately earned, deserved, and needed. With that said, a brief word or two. Be sure and let these folks know you're watching, and I'll be right back with more of your news today after this. To get high-speed internet on their state-of-the-art fiber optic network for all of your home and business solutions, or to watch TV without a contract on over 200 digital channels with superb quality, or stay connected with family and friends with 24/7 telephone service you can always depend on, contact Foothills Broadband today. Or just click on their link to the right to find out how they're working to provide the latest in communications at affordable prices with exceptional service at Foothills Broadband. Before we dive into Community Day and the tens of thousands of dollars that were distributed just a couple of nights ago and how much you all had a hand in that, we'll go to tonight's community calendar announcements brought to you by McGoffin Farm Bureau, your weather forecast, funeral service listings that I have sadly to pass along as well. I'll begin with a couple of announcements that I don't have typed in, but I need to make mention of. Once again, the second annual Fall Festival has been set for this Saturday in the Ramey Park from noon to 4 with raffles, games, gift bags, costume contest, pumpkin painting, food, cornhole tournament, and more. It's all free and it's all fun for the whole family. And another reminder from the New Bethel Assembly of God of Burning Fork, they're having homecoming and pastor appreciation day this Sunday. Dinner will follow the service. Bring someone with you, they say, and join them as they say. Pastor Adair says it will be a wonderful time to come and be blessed. New Bethel Assembly of God of Burning Fork this Sunday, homecoming and pastor appreciation day. A bit out of order, but nonetheless, a very happy birthday starts off the rest of calendar announcements.
This says, I have a birthday for today. Please wish Tony Brust a happy 6th birthday with lots of love from his mommy, mamaw, and papaw. Happy birthday, Tony. Happy big 6th birthday to you. I have a lost dog I'd like to pass along to you. It's a yellow lab. It's older in age. Answers to the name Forrest. About 75, 80 pounds. Could be wearing two collars and part of a broken leash. There's a $50 reward. If you have any information about the lost pet, call Jim or Diane Joseph at 884-8771. 884-8771. That's in the Meadows area of McGoffin County in the Route 7 area. A benefit fun horse show has been set in honor of Mike Day and Ivan Howard this Saturday at 1 in the Morgan County Equestrian Park. They've got like 29 classes. They've got first place ribbons, second and third place as well. $3 for adults to get in. Kids 8 and under get in for free. $10 to enter a class. If you have any questions, call those numbers, 743-7504 or 743-4558. That's this Saturday, 1 o'clock at the Morgan County Equestrian Park. And if you've got a calendar announcement, birthday, anniversary, or otherwise, send them to me. Let me tell everyone about it. Do it for free. Always have. Always will. And remember, you can catch the show the following day if you missed it on Howard's Cable, Foothills Channel 40, on yournewstoday.com. a reminder about services to be held in honor of 78-year-old Joe Darrell Pennington of Dayton, Ohio, who passed away on the 17th, survived by his wife, Barbara. He's also survived by two sons and a daughter. A brief visitation starts in the morning at 10. Services will begin tomorrow at 1, all of which from the Magoffin County Funeral Home Chapel. And I also have a listing tonight in honor of 55-year-old Raymond Miller of Middle Fork, who passed away on the 20th, survived by his wife, Trella Cheney Miller, sons Joshua, James, and Jacob, and daughter Kristen. A brief visitation will be taking place tomorrow morning at 11, with services tomorrow afternoon at 1, all of which from the Sagersville Funeral Home.
At this point, we've already experienced the 12th annual Magoffin County Community Day, and then following thereafter on the program, of course, we spoke with a whole lot of folks about how much fun they had and how much support there was to help a lot of local nonprofits raise so much money, and they're approaching that $1 million mark certainly every year, but getting really close to that now with this year behind them. During the ceremony where they presented the checks just a few nights ago, of course, there was a lot of thanks to go around. Scotty B. Patrick, the creator and founder of the Community Day Foundation in Magoffin County, Donna Sager, everyone at the Sagersville National Bank, the Community Day Foundation, Joy Global, the City of Sagersville, all the businesses, all the individuals, all the clubs, all those who showed up in the Ramey Park to support this event in one form or fashion. Lana and everyone at the Sagersville National Bank, we have to mention them again. Jessica Allen and the Key Club, Jennifer Howard and the Beta Club, Paul Burchell, as well as we can't forget the Kentucky Mission Bible Training Center, who helped out big time and who was also one of the many groups receiving what turned out to be nearly $90,000 in cash. It wasn't a record-setting event in attendance, but in some other very important ways, it was. Here's Scotty B. and Donna Sager with the check presentation.
We also want to thank the people of Magoffin County. You know, over the years, they've been very, very generous to our nonprofit groups, and that's what it's all about. Working together, helping people, and so the people of Magoffin County have responded, and you work very, very hard, and the results show.
We're going to give out $89,248.50 this afternoon.
Wow.
The groups had a record year this year. They themselves, on the day of Community Day, raised $56,395.89.
That's a record. That's a record.
That's the most that the groups themselves has ever raised.
Right.
The Magoffin County Senior Citizens, $2,228.14.
Marlene, come up.
For the month of September, we delivered 891 meals. We served 551 meals in the dining room. We served 87 different people visit our dining room to eat, and we served 51 different people meals on wheels. That's just an example of some of the services we do.
David Bloomington Fire Department, $2,778.87.
The money we got here today, we're going to use it to general upkeep of the building. We're trying to buy us that new tanker or a used tanker, either one. It was hard this year to get this money. We appreciate everything from everybody, Joy Global, Mayor, you all, and food was good. We appreciate it all. So thank you.
South Magoffin Fire Department, $13,047.78.
Wow.
Newest ones in this business, but I can't believe how all of our other stations in the county has helped us, and we've got the mutual aid agreement with at least three I know of out of the county, and I don't know how we done the most. I know Leo Hill, our captain, had a lot to do with it, because he got that lawnmower and he worked extremely hard. Thank you.
The mission teams, $1,582.49.
Those of you that may not know what Mission Teens is all about is we're right there on Parkway Drive, right next to the True Value, and we're a discipleship program. is a program for men and women that have tried everything else to get free of drugs and being able to live life on life terms and to become willing to give Jesus Christ an opportunity to show them a better way of life. And the program is free. Doesn't cost anything to come there, but it does cost to keep the doors open. We don't get any money or anything from the state. Everything is taken care of by donations. The Lord touches people's hearts, turns people's hearts, and they just show up at our doors with food and money to help pay our rent, from our rent to our utilities to our toilet paper, even our paper towels. Everything is by donation. We don't solicit anything. Jesus Christ takes care of everything. So this is a gift from the Lord, and we truly appreciate it.
Sandersville Fire Department, $10,258.54.
Last year's money we used to purchase a mini pumper that you see around town. Between that and the money that John Short helped us with, Cole Severance and the mayor from the city council, we bought another piece of equipment to help everybody in the community. This year we're going to look at another piece of equipment. We haven't decided yet. Our Jaws of Life is getting about 15 years on it, so most likely we'll try to get the Jaws of Life.
The REACH program, $2,798.24.
This money will mostly be focused for drug prevention and drug education. That's where we always come up short. So we do drug education in the 7th and 8th grade, middle school. Actually, we'll do drug education anywhere anybody calls us to come to. We don't have a whole lot of calls, but we're open anytime for anything. So we do all that, and then I do a support group meeting. And we also we help people going to rehabs and anything they need to get into, but that's pretty much covered. This is mostly used for the drug education and drug prevention program.
North McGoffin Fire Department, $9,631.87.
Money really comes in. We use it more or less in our general fund. We keep the lights on, pay the bills. What you can't use grant money or stuff like that for, all that has to be what you make or what you donate or get donated. So we use it to keep the doors open and to keep it going and maybe to keep saving some lives.
Got the DAV, $4,258.50.
On behalf of the Disabled American Veterans here in McGoffin County, we'd like to thank the community for all your support. This money would greatly help us in our operation to all the veterans here in McGoffin County. We thank you again very much.
Dawkins Trail, $1,224.03.
We're glad to be here and we're excited about the Dawkins Line Rail to Trail. And I'll tell you what, after what I witnessed at Royalton here just recently, I'm very excited. Royalton has become the 10th trail town in the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And they have worked so hard, and I just look forward to what that we can do as a county and what this will bring to McGoffin County.
The rescue squad is $6,953.12.
The lights on, paying the bills, of course, of last year, 2014, we entered 261 runs. They involved 22,760 man hours. This year, up till September 30th, we're already at 260 runs at 21,664 man hours. Wear and tear on vehicles. And that's basically where we go besides keeping the lights on like that. So we're not looking forward to the winter because I understand we could be a little bit worse than last year. So this will help keep the trucks going and we'll be out there when the time calls and when we're needed, as always, 24/7, 365.
The McGoffin County Woman's Club, $3,631.82.
Everyone, we do scholarships for the high school. We help with the senior trip. We help with the nursing home. We help with the children at Christmas. We do all we can to help the community. And selling our little pecans isn't enough. So we appreciate everything. Pecans will be in the end of the month. If anybody wants any, call me.
Okay.
The Middle Fork Fire Department, $9,448.51.
We really need this. Our account was getting low. We got a lot of things we need, like I say, keep the lights on and just everything we need. But you all don't know how much we appreciate it, especially Scotty and the bank. This right here is the number one man.
The Kiwanis Club, $1,300.27.
The Kiwanis Club worked really hard to help children in our community. That's our mission. So a portion of this money is going to go to scholarships for high school seniors that want to further their education. So we really appreciate you all and all the work that you do. Thanks.
The McGoffin County Civil War, $3,441.92.
For the past 5 years, we've done numerous events, reenactments, Chautauquas. We had one Saturday night. Had Grandpa Jones and Colonel Harlan Sanders. If you missed it, you missed a great show. But I just want to thank everybody. And this money will allow us to continue bringing events to McGoffin County.
District 3 Fire Department, $9,132.59.
We want to thank everybody that had anything to do with the community day, helped in any way, especially Scotty and the bank and George Oakland. We just thank everybody. This money's going to be used to buy a new truck. We got a new tanker. We'll be here. Probably the last of the week or the first of next week. And we've got the money to pay for it.
Miss McGoffin Scholarship.
I'll pick it up with the Miss McGoffin Scholarship Pageant Committee in just a few moments. Right now, just one or maybe two other folks that we have to thank. And the first being the one that actually catered the event for the Community Day ceremony and who can cater your next event as well.
Livers or gizzards? Gizzards or livers? Or you can have both, and you can have them any day of the week, or you can have them for under $5 when they're Friday special at your Sagersville Lee's Famous Recipe. On Fridays, get a liver or gizzard or liver and gizzard dinner for only $4.59, $3.99 after 4 o'clock. Only at your Sagersville Lee's Famous Recipe.
McGoffin Scholarship, $2,427.59.
Without this money, we just couldn't operate throughout the year. We have our pageants during Labor Day weekend. I think about 3,000 people attended the free events that we put on during Founders Day. And with the money, we use it for scholarships for our winners, and our contestants participate throughout the year in various community projects, and we also give a portion to Children's Miracle Network for hospitals in Kentucky. Thank you all so much.
Boy Scouts Troop 862, $2,050.90.
We help the young boys ages 11 to 18 keep out and learn a little bit about what they need to be when they grow up. This will help buy us equipment and help pay for them to go to camp.
Say something good about this young lady. When her father passed away, she stepped up and became a scoutmaster, and I think it really shows that so thank you very, very much.
Okay, South McGoffin activist, $2,563.98.
I'd like to thank all who have participated in Community Day, the sponsors, especially the people who come by our booth and buy a ticket or a chance. This money will go toward building a community center in South McGoffin. I don't know if all of you know, but we've been working on this for about 5 years, and this week we got the old school torn down. By the efforts of Ron Reed, we would like to thank him publicly for doing that. And now we all have to work together to get the debris moved. And our architect, Neil McCall, is with us this evening as a special guest who is advising us on how to go about getting the debris, what we need to do to get rid of it, and also what we need to do to prepare the land for a brand new community center. So, and the cultural arts building. We'll be doing this year after year after year for a long time to pay for that, but we appreciate all the help that we have been given and will continue to get. Thank you very much.
The Christians Care Fund, $889.34.
I have to say that I don't know whether people in McGoffin County realize the extent that the commitment of this one man and his vision has made to McGoffin County. Starting the McGoffin County Community Foundation, starting McGoffin County Community Day, all of the money, all of the time, all of the love and all of the attention that he gives to the people in his hometown is phenomenal. So thank you, Scott.
Thank you. We've run out of money. Donna, would you like to say a thank you to some people?
I want to thank some of the people that, if it had not been for them, Community Day would not be what it is. I want to thank Lana and the bank employees. They do a great job. Jessica Allen and her Key Club. Jennifer Howard and the Beta Club. Paul Burchell and his employees. And Kathy Puckett, Karen and JR, for all the work that they do to put this together. So, please give them a big hand.
As we look back over the past 12 years, you know, we've had our ups and downs. We've had bad weather, we had economic conditions and other challenges, but we've overcome each of those. And I think this has been to the benefit of McGoffin County and all of our groups. What we tried to do is provide a day of fun for the people of McGoffin County, and hopefully they will reward us with opening their pocketbooks so that you all can get some money to do the activities and so forth. So it's been a good partnership between the community and our nonprofits. But you know, if you're not improving yourself, you're standing still, and if you're standing still, maybe you're beginning to fall behind, and we don't want that to happen. So we've been scratching our head of what can we do to make Community Day even more relevant for the people of McGoffin County. None of us at the Community Foundation have all the bright ideas, so we would like to have each of those people in this room, if you've got a good idea of what we could do as a group to make Community Day more relevant for our people and hopefully get some more money for your activities, we'd like your ideas. We thank everyone for coming. I think this is our biggest crowd, and we hope that next year, we're already working on it, makes it even better for y'all. So congratulations, y'all worked hard, but we appreciate your doing it. Thank you.